Hey everybody, we are here on the show floor for E3 day one. I'm Hayden Dingman for PC World, and we just saw a Intel Y-Gig demo, the wireless VR tech that they showed off at Computex a few weeks ago. It's a lot bulkier than I maybe expected, but that is a prototype hardware that we saw today. Basically, it's just removing the wires from the HTC Vives that you can move around, you know, duck, all that. We've seen a couple of instances of wireless VR tech now, but I think this is probably the first time that it was coming from like a big enough company like Intel to really make a push into the market. As I said, it's a little bit bulkier than I expected. It sits up on the back of your head, and when you lean forward and lean back, you can sort of feel it shift around. But I would say it's actually pretty comparable to the ribbon cable that came with the original HTC Vive. That thing also had a tendency to slip around on your head when you were using it. And it's a pretty modular piece of tech. It just slides on like a belt buckle. And so you could technically use it with the new Deluxe Audio strap. You can use it with the original Elastic. And Intel said HTC is the one that they're demoing here, but it's not exactly a headset-specific set of technology. That's just the implementation that we're seeing. So LG's headset coming out later this year, you can technically do it. The Oculus, I don't know. They don't have swappable cables, I don't think, and I don't know how it would work, but maybe they can make it work in some way. And then PlayStation VR, obviously, we'll see if it ever makes it over there. I don't think Sony would necessarily invest in that tech. They're not really interested in room scale, which is where this would matter the most, but you know, there's always the possibility. On the PC side of things, it's a PCIe add-on card, but that's what you need to power that low latency VR tech. And the latency was really good. I played some Space Pirate Trainer, a game that we played at launch for the HTC Vive. That game has a lot more stuff in it than I remembered, but I was able to duck around, shoot all these robots that were coming at me. Never noticed any latency, except a few times I would bend my head forward. The sensor would obscure the lighthouse tracking, and we'd get a few seconds of jitter as the headset tried to figure out where it was. But Intel says that's also a production issue. They're gonna, you know, when they license this tech out to HTC, HTC is going to make that Y-Gig. Hopefully they'll get it more back on the back of the head so that it's not flopping in front of the tracking. But yeah, they're not willing to talk about a price or a release date yet. They did say within the next 12 months we should see this technology. So if you're, you know, looking forward to getting rid of those wires, hopefully that's right around the corner. Maybe it'll even make it into the HTC Vive 2 whenever we see that, if we ever see that. But yeah, I don't know. We'll see in the future. For PC World, I am Hayden Dingman. And again, we are at E3 for the next 3 days. So expect many more videos from us and many more articles.